and happy Sunday. Hope you're having a wonderful one. Why don't you get on your phone right now, text about 5, 10, maybe 15 people, say, let's do a Bible study. I have a word I want to pray, and I really believe this is a word of positioning that God has for you. In my spirit this morning, I've been in prayer. I've been just watching service online and excited about what God's doing, and I keep hearing God's getting ready to take you to a higher place. God's getting ready to take you to a higher place. Come up hither. Get ready to go higher. And I'm talking to you in spiritual terms. As you text some people out and get ready, get your Bible, get your journal, whatever you want to do, get ready for prayer, I want you to know, I believe right now as I release this word, it's a prophetic word. It's a word from the Lord. It's a word directly for you, and God is going to give you some direction. If we look at Revelation chapter 4, verse 1 and 2, first off, the Apostle Paul has been boiled in hot oil. You talk about going through it. He's in a cave called a grotto. Sometimes it's in the deepest, darkest places that God gives us the greatest revelation. Maybe your circumstance, your situation right now looks impossible, looks bad. It looks like, my gosh, how in the world? But it's in the pit that God is positioning you for the palace, Joseph. It's in the cave. It's in the place of obscurity, the place of barrenness, that God bursts his greatness. Why? Because he doesn't want any man to have glory. He wants everyone to stand back and say, look what the Lord has done. I don't know who's in an impossible situation that it looks like, man, I'm locked up in chains here. I'm in this cave called a grotto. Physically, I mean, it's horrific. It's just an impossible situation, but great revelation is getting ready to come. God is going to use where there's absolutely nothing in the natural that can bring forth manifestation or glory to God. And God is going to use that situation, because I want you to understand the circumstance. So I'm going to read to you Revelation chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. John says this. He says, after this, I looked, and there before me was a door standing open in heaven. God is opening a door that no man can shut. And I'll show you that that's not just heaven and eternity, that God is opening a door in the realm of the spirit, a door in the high places for you, a door that Job talks about. There is a place in God that no fowler, no young adder, no lion, no can access. There's a place that you're seated far above principalities and powers and darkness and wickedness. There's a door, and the voice I'd first heard speaking to me, like a trumpet, a clarion call, and God sending out a clarion call right now, said, come up here. One version says, come up hither, or come up higher, and I will show you. I'm going to reveal to you. Get ready for your eyes to be open right now. Get ready for God to show you things, secrets, sacred secrets, mysteries, revelation about your family, about your purpose, about your ministry, about 2019, about what God is getting ready to do. Come up hither and I will show you, you ready? What must take place after this. God has some musts that are going to happen for you. God has some things that have already been ordered, aligned, positioned in the spirit. It might look impossible in the natural, but I'm telling you, my spirit is so excited. I have faith and expectation. You're getting ready to land this year strong, enter into one of the best seasons. And though it might look bad in the natural, though it might look impossible, it's a setup by God. Remember, you must decrease so he can increase. So he said, at once I was in the spirit. God is taking you to a place in the spirit, even during this broadcast, even during this time that we're talking. I was in the spirit, and there before me was a throne in heaven with someone sitting on it. I feel a mandate to deliver by God, to properly position you, to get you ready, to say, come up higher. Now, first off, he said, I looked, I saw, not I will see, I saw a door, a portal. It's an opening. Heaven has opened some things to you right now. I'm speaking to you prophetically. I'm speaking to you by the Spirit of God. There's some areas of access that have been orchestrated and opened by God, that as you move into the Spirit, first, I know in the natural than in the spirit, you're going to see God do some things. There's access that has been given where before the enemy said denied, or there were delays or shut doors or cycles. But God's saying, I've opened some things up spiritually to you. Nations, cities, families, favor, positions. I believe God has exalted your horn, your authority, and will bring honor to his name according to Psalm 112, that this is a new day, a new time. Things that have been shut off are now being opened up. I want you to hear in heaven. Now, when he says in heaven, heaven's not speaking here as in the final eternal destination like we're saying. You don't need things opened up in eternity. There'll be fullness there. It means literally to rise through the idea of elevation as lifting itself above the plane, to be elevated, to raise or to lift to a higher position. It means a mountain. So God's calling you to a higher place, to a place of elevation, to a mountain where he'll reveal his secrets like he did in Genesis chapter 22. He takes Abraham up to Mount Moriah and he reveals himself. How he does with Moses, he takes him up into the mountain and he reveals himself. Then there's this trumpet, which is a clarion call, a clear word from God, vision and revelation. And he says to him, come up higher. The word come up means to climb, to grow, to rise up. God is getting ready to cause you to rise up in the spirit realm, to grow, to climb up higher. And higher, or some translation says hither, literally means this place. And I will show you what must take place. It's throne room ministry. The realm are dimensions where excellent ministry, or the more excellent ministry flows, are the most holy place. This is a place of maturity in Jesus Christ. This is a place that God wants to reveal things to you. This is a place that where you'll see an outflow of the indwelling of Christ. It's kind of like John 7:38. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. The word flow literally means rheo, R-H-E-O. The English word is rhetoric, and it means there are faith-filled words that are going to flow. There's word on the inside of you that's getting ready. God's presence will impregnate you to produce. You will be fruitful. You will see your harvest come to pass. But first, you must come up higher. And these are the few points I want to give you real quick. Just when you thought the winds of adversity were blowing, it's going to be not against you, but for you, because it's going to bring you opportunity. It's time to come up higher, come up hither, and this is the main thing. So in our text, as you see, or in this is Revelation chapter 4, you see where the Revelator, John the Revelator, is on the Isle of Patmos, and he delivers one of the most profound, prolific words out of this cave called a grotto, where chains are wrapped around him. He's locked up with murderers, rapists, prisoners, all for preaching the gospel. Think about the kind of persecution that he went through. Number one, he's in a cave, but he's hearing from God. You might be in a dark place. You might be surrounded in a impossible place, in a place that seems like, man, I'm limited, I'm locked in, but God is sending revelation to you. And this is it. I know I've got to wrap this up, but I've got so much to share with you. What happens here is God brings the strongest revelation message from the deepest dungeoness, from the pit, from the cave of grotto, and often some of the greatest anointings in our life. You'll see that all prophets come out of barrenness, and there's a reason for that. I'll do a teaching on that soon. Often the greatest anointing is birth in your greatest place of adversity and pain. In fact, if you could see the magnitude of the blessing ahead of you, you would understand the size of the battle that you're going through. It would make sense, because what you've gone through is just really an indication of what you are now positioned for. So here he is, not at the Hilton sipping on tea. He's not at the Hyatt or in a nice hotel room like I am right now. He is literally in a grotto. He's been boiled in hot oil. He's in this horrible condition, and God is getting ready to speak to him. Revelation doesn't come from someone's book or tape or another message. Revelation comes from places that God has pruned us and purged us, and he's doing a work on the inside of us. It's more than just learning scripture. It's living scripture. And so he goes on, and here's where I want to take you. I know I've got so much to share with you. The Bible says that Jesus tells him to write three things. You ready? And I want to show it to you. He says, number one, write about what you've seen. He says, number two, write the things that are. But number three, I want you to tell about the things that shall be hereafter. I don't know who I'm speaking to, but this is where I'm zoning in right now. Because the enemy was not intimidated about what happened back in 1950 or back at Azusa or back in 1999 or in your life or in your ministry in 2003 or 4 or 15 or even 16 or 17. Yeah, write about those things. Write about what happened. And write about where you are. But this is where it takes someone very spiritual. This is where the enemy is battling you, because he does not want the prophetic prayer, the word of God with an anointing for now that breaks the chains, set the captives free, destroys the yoke, brings your family out, heals your body, brings not just a word like repetitive religious routine words, but the word of the Lord that is now, that is fresh, that is powerful, that is profound. He says, and write the things hereafter. God's getting ready to give you revelation. Revelation about your ministry. Revelation about your purpose. Revelation about your children. Revelation about your family. Revelation and unveiling an extraordinary, not just knowledge, but an extraordinary removing of a veil, that you have the understanding, the wisdom of God. So he says this, write the things hereafter. So he writes and describes the vision. Number one, I saw the one clothed with a garment down the feet, a golden girdle. He was in the midst of seven candlesticks. His head and his hair was white as wool. His eyes a flame and fire. And it goes on to describe what he saw. Number two, write the things which are. And he writes to the seven churches, Thyra, and Pergamos, and Sardis, and Laodicea, and Philadelphia, and Ephesus. And he goes on to write them. But he gets ready to write things which shall be hereafter. And God says, hold up, wait a minute. And here's the word of the Lord to you. In order to write the hereafter, in order to write the future, that's vision, that's revelation. You have to come up higher. You have to come up hither. There's a place I'm taking you, and that's what the enemy has been fighting you about, and I'm about to pray over you, because he never wanted you to get to the higher place. I'm not talking in the natural. I'm not talking about just a new job. Yes, there's no way that you can ascend spiritually and not ascend naturally. There's no way that you can go to high places in God and it not translate here into the earth, and you go to high places, but it's not a high place that you're going to have to fight for or manipulate for or make your way into. Listen, God's going to remove some people. God's going to shut down those people who are obstructing you and holding you back from the plan and the purpose, because when you go up high in the spirit, God is going to download strategy. He's going to give you the mind of Christ and the wisdom of God. He's going to give you an anointing and a boldness that you're going to be able to see, not by eyes of the natural, but by your spirit. You're going to see through eyes of revelation. He says, come up hither. In other words, when it comes to your destiny, when it comes to your future, when it comes to your purpose, and you're getting ready to enter into a strategic year for Paula White Ministry, I'm telling you, it's going to be one of the best years ever. I know that. I'm excited about all the things you're doing. He says, when it comes to your destiny, when it comes to your future, when it comes to your purpose, you cannot stay on the same level. I posted today on my Instagram, I said, God has shut some doors in your life, and he caused your circumstances to make those doors shut, because he knew that you wouldn't get out of your comfort zone. So trust him in transition. See, what he's telling you right now is you have to come up, and that is what has been going on in your life. God is repositioning. He's sending you favor. He's going to suddenly shift you. See, God can snap his fingers and move you from a pit to a palace. He can give an interpretation for dreams. Even though the baker and the butler forsake you, listen, God will give you the word of the Lord in your mouth so that you can speak into the heart of the king. You can speak into your boss, into your neighbor. You can have a word of knowledge, a word of revelation that will shift everything into their life and reveal who Jesus Christ is. So here's the battle, because everything is trying to hold you back from getting up to see yourself in your destined state. Your situation is trying to hold you back. Words that have been spoken over you are trying to hold you back. Society, culture, trying to hold you back. Lies from your past are trying to hold you back. But the devil is a liar. So two things I want you to do quickly. Number one, that's why Paul said and commanded in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, lay aside every weight that so easily does beset you. And Philippians chapter 3, verse 13, forgetting those things that are behind you and pressing, to press means to resist that which would resist you. Whatever is resisting you right now, man's opinion, people's judgment, maybe it's something on your record, maybe it's a mistake you made, something on your resume, something you didn't do, maybe it's a bankruptcy filing, maybe it's bad credit, maybe it is a divorce you went through, maybe it's emotional baggage. He said, resist that which would resist you. Maybe it's your mom abandoned you, or your dad left you, or he said you'll never be anything. Whatever it is, resist that which would resist you, forgetting those things that are behind you, and press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling. Why? Because you're not a victim to your circumstances. You're not a victim to that situation. You're not a victim to your genetic makeup. You're not a victim to what society has profiled you to be. But you are who Christ says you are, an ambassador of the Most High God, an heir with God, and a joint heir with Jesus Christ. You have to see yourself as you really are in order to come up higher. So I want to pray over you right now. God's saying, I'm taking you to a high place. I've seated you in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Now, you can't stay on the same level. This year's not going to be a repeat year. 2019's not going to be a groundhog year for you. But God's getting ready to lift you up to a higher place. Let's come in agreement. Everything, listen, that's fighting, take off every self-place embargo. Any word you've spoken of yourself, repent of it. Break it. Declare that any word that does not line up with God's word will not be fruitful. Repent, which means I change my mind. I change my direction. I receive you, Jesus Christ, as my Lord and Savior. And any word spoken by myself, spoken by others, that is not in alignment with the word of God is broken over my life right now. Let's pray. Father, I come in agreement in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the things of the past. We thank you for things right now. But Lord, I recognize you're showing us strategies for 2019, for 2020, 22, 25, and beyond, that you're establishing your kingdom here in the earth, and that your voice is being established through your servants, your sons and your daughters, that you are showing them not just knowledge, not just man's wisdom, but you're giving them revelation. You're revealing to them the mysteries, the sacred secrets, for their family members, for their child. You'll give them instruction. You'll show them what to do and how to do it. And right now, let every veil be removed. I block and break every spirit of fear, for God has not given you a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of sound mind. I declare that you have the mind of Christ according to Philippians 2:5, and that you do hold the thoughts of the Messiah. The Bible declares that if you keep your mind upon him, he will keep you in perfect peace. The joy of the Lord is your strength. He has given you a grace that is sufficient. So whatever you are facing, according to the book of Corinthians, in your weakness, his strength is made perfect. In this vessel, this earthen vessel, he has given you a deposit of wealth. There's great treasure on the inside of you. I declare you will go forth. And according to Revelation chapter 4, God has opened a portal, a door in heaven, not just eternity, but in the realm of the spirit for you to access. And he's going to show you, open your eyes that you may see. Lord, Ephesians 1, 17 and 18 says that the eyes of our understanding might be enlightened, that we may know what is the hope of the riches of the glory of the inheritance of our saints. Come up higher. John, in a cave, bound, got his greatest revelation. Your circumstances don't prevent God being big in your life. Let me say hi to a few people. Aaron, God bless you. Struggling with comparison with evil that comes with it, we break it and overturn it in the name of Jesus. Lola, God bless you. Mary, amen. Jay, thanks for being a top fan. Believe and receive. We come in agreement. God bless you. Pastor, amen. You will go forth hope. Stephanie, claim it for yourself. Daniel, praise God. Lisa, love you guys. Kimberly, thanks. Logged on late. So good to always talk to you, Kimberly. And you can re-catch this. I mean, I really felt I had a word of the Lord. So I love you guys. I'm praying for you and know that God has you. Pray for each other. Remember, Paula White Ministries is doing incredible things. If you're not a partner with us, partner with Paula White Ministry. Go to www.paulawhite.org. I have released so much new content and product. We're talking about generational blessings and cursings and how to break that cycle curse, because I feel so adamantly strong that this year you have to enter into 2019, not miss another moment. And I really take you through how you do that. There's great stuff. There's blogs. There's product. I just want to be your pastor. I want to, if you already have a pastor, listen, I want to be your mentor. I want to stand with you. If you don't have a place that you're connected to, connect with us at Paula White Ministry and New Destiny Christian Center. You know, the Bible says, bring a tithe into the storehouse, sow a seed and be a blessing, and know that we're always doing great things. I'm here for you. Let's do life together. Let's do God together, and let's see him be exalted. Love you. Talk to you again real soon.